Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of power plant. The topic is steam power plant, question number 9 from engineering central conventional fluid mechanics. A steam power plant generating 500 megawatt of electric power. Electric power employs a network circulation boiler which supplies steam at a pressure of 150 bar and temperature of 550 Celsius. The condenser pressure is 0.05 bar. The turbine mechanical and generator efficiencies are 87%, 98% and 99% respectively. The boiler uses pulverized coal having a calorific value of 26 megajoule per kilogram and yields 92% efficiency. The feed water passing through the feed heaters enters the boiler at 160 degrees Celsius. The risers of the furnace are 55 meter high, while the downcomers are placed outside the furnace for producing network circulation. The quantity of steam at the top of the riser is 12% and a minimum exit velocity of mixture leaving the riser and entering the drum is 1.4 meter per second. The dimensions of the riser tubes are 65 mm OD and 3 mm wall thickness, while the dimensions of downcomers are 185 mm OD and 8 mm thick. Assume no pressure drop and heat loss to the riser. Work out the problem. 1. Sketch the layout of natural circulation boiler unit showing furnace, drum, riser, downcomer, superheater, heater and economizer and show the process on PLA. 2. The generation of rate of steam, ignoring the amount of steam led off to the pre-water heater in kilogram per second. 3. Rate of fuel flow required in kilogram per second. 4. The evaporation factor. 5. The circulation ratio. 6. The number of riser tubes. 7. The number of downcomers. 8. State reasons for selecting fewer in number and bigger in diameter as downcomers, while more in number and smaller in diameter as risers. Riser tubes in natural circulation boiler. Take the following property. These properties are given: H1, H2S, HF3, HF5, row riser, top and row downcomers. Where suffix 1, 2, 3 and 5 denote boiler exit or turbine inlet, condenser exit, pump inlet or and boiler inlet respectively. Okay, so this is the question. So first part is to draw the schematic diagram. Okay. So this is the schematic diagram. So this is your riser. Okay. This is your riser. This is your downcomer. This is your superheater. This is heater. This is economizer. Okay. And this is riser. And now we'll calculate the other part. So here the TS diagram, this is your boiler exit, this is turbine exit, this is pump inlet, this is pump exit. And enthalpy at 1 is given, that is 344846. And enthalpy at 2, S is also given, that is 1987 kilojoule per kilogram. And power generated by the plant is given, that is 500 megawatt. Okay. And let omega s be the rate of generation of steam and turbine efficiency, mechanical efficiency and generator efficiency are given. These are given. Okay. So now power generated by turbine is omega s into H1 minus H2s. Omega s is rate of steam generation per second. So this power generated by turbine and power delivered by plant is will multiply the efficiency, turbine efficiency, mechanical efficiency, generator efficiency, and that is given as 500 megawatt or 503 kilowatt. So now putting these values, you can find out omega is from 405.285 kilogram per second. Okay. This is the answer to this part. Rate of steam generation. What is the amount of steam? and the third part is rate of fuel flow required in kilometer. Rate of fuel flow required in per second. For omega f is the rate of fuel flow required in per second, and it is also given the boiler efficiency is given. In boiler efficiency is power generated by turbine by heat supplied by the boiler, and power generated by turbine is this quantity, and heat supplied by the boiler is omega f into calorific value, omega f into calorific value, and omega f is omega p, we have to find out, and our calorific value is 26 megajoules, and boiler efficiency is 92%. So putting this value, we can find out omega. Omega f comes out at 24.70. So next question is evaporation factor is just the ratio of omega s by omega f. That comes out at 16.30. And next is the circulation ratio. Circulation ratio is 1 by Dynes fraction at the top of riser, and that the Dynes fraction is given as 12%, so it will be 1 by 1.12, so that is 8.33. Next is number of riser tubes. Number of riser tubes is, let me find out like this. So we find out the rate of steam formation in riser, in one riser. So as the outer diameter of the riser is given, and in thickness of the riser tube is given, that is outer diameter of the riser is 65 mm thickness. So we can find out inner diameter. So inner diameter comes out as 65 mm, and density of steam is given, that is this quantity, go to. That is 396, and velocity is given, that is 1.4. Velocity is given, that is 1.4 meter per second. That is the velocity. Velocity is given 1.4 meter per second. So from this we can find out the mass flow rate of riser through one riser, that is 0.181 kilogram per second, and number of riser are omega s by omega, so that will be 2226. So next is number of downcomers, again by following the same procedure. Here the as in downcomer the water is flowing, so that is the mass flow of rate of through one downcomer is 5/4 dB² go down into BL, and here is same as that of that in riser, that is 1.2. So and outer diameter of the down cover is given as 185 mm, and thickness is given as 8. So inner diameter will come out as 185 mm. So number of down covers are omega s by omega s, mass flow rate, total mass flow rate same. So that is 21.41 or K22. So number of downcomers are 22 and number of risers are 2226. So as this is the riser, this is your riser and this is your downcomer. In riser the we have to transfer heat. Okay, so the area of the riser should be more, surface area of the riser should be more as compared to downcomers. Whereas in downward we have to transfer water, so there is no need to increase the surface area. So for transferring heat, the number of risers should be more to provide more surface area. Okay. So as no heat is transferred in downcomer, so number of tubes are fewer. Here again, heat transfer is required in risers, so to provide large area, so heat transfer number of tubes should be more.